Hey, if I can find all five of these screws, it'll be a miracle.
Welcome back to another episode of the Man Event. Today, we're going to be replacing the headlight on a 2019 Corvette Stingray. And Chief, this isn't the first time we've had to replace a headlight at this house.
No, this is the second time. The first time was a manufacturer problem. This one, just a mistake that she didn't really make. She was driving down the interstate and some debris came up and hit her right in the headlight here. You see it's been temporarily fixed with some tape, but we're gonna go ahead and fix that today.
And what did the dealer want to make this repair?
Wow, so we went to the dealer and they wanted $2,400. Hila, why don't you bring in the headlight and tell us about that?
All right, so the Chief scored this headlight on carid.com right around $700, so we figure the savings by doing it yourself, roughly $1,500.
Yeah, $1,500, that math checks out.
First step in removing the headlight assembly is to loosen and remove the fascia and the bumper. In order to do that, we've got to remove the inner wheel liner, which requires a loosening 3 10-millimeter bolts. After we do that, we'll pull it up on the rims. So we had to do a bit of a modification. We weren't able to use the ramps that we intended to use. They had too steep of an incline, so we resorted to just jacking up the car. Pro tip, if your jack is too high, in other words, it won't go underneath the car, you can use some wood, drive your car up on that, and then that should give you enough room to get the jack underneath and jack her on up.
All right, and brake.
Chief is the shortest of us. He's the guy that gets to do all the under the car stuff. That's his wife's car. Anyway, so he's busy underneath there taking off the trim pieces that kind of help with the road noise. They're just plastic pieces. They're full of 10-millimeter, 7-millimeter bolts. Pro tip, start taking stuff off, put them in a little Ziploc bag, mark them so you know where they went. That way you don't have any spare parts after the fact. Next step after that, there's another piece underneath there that separates the air intake from the bumper. And those require, what, 4 7-millimeters?
Five 7-millimeters,
you just took them off right there. We're moving in a groove. Next up are 4 T30 bolts. After those 4 bolts, you want to use a trim tool to release these 2 trim pieces. Now that all the fasteners are loose on the front bumper fascia, we need to pull this away and get this marker light and loosen this up so the wires don't come with the bumper. If you don't have a plastic trim tool, you can use some painter's tape to protect your paint. Obviously this headlight is already damaged, so we're not too concerned with that.
What are you going to pull? How much are you going to pull back here?
That's fine. Alright, so we have the driver's side free. We're going to attempt to remove this without taking the entire bumper off. It just seems to be a little less complicated. There's only 3 bolts that hold this lens assembly in. There's one kind of where my finger's pointing, a second over here, and the third one is kind of right here. Back there behind the wiring harness assembly.
This is the easy one.
So there's 7 millimeter.
You're supposed to be 7 millimeter. Back here, you have to be careful. I just unpull this this locking tab right here, give it a wiggle, and oh, there it is.
The old one's out, new one's going in. We just tested it. It does function as it should. So now it's just a matter of fishing this guy in and bolting it out.
Sounds right.
Yep.
Looking for the first. Do the pros do it like this? With the extender on the extender?
They do today.
Yeah, they do.
All right, so we got the light in. We've got the bumper back secured up here on the top and on the sides. We've connected that light back up. We're basically just reverse engineering this process. The Chief is in there now, underneath, putting the screws in for the undercarriage protection.
Hey, if I can find all five of these screws, it'll be a miracle. They're everywhere, man.
Happened.
All right, so hey, total time on this project, including filming for us, for a couple of guys that are not mechanics, was only 2 hours. So if I break the math down,
so you give it about 90 minutes?
Dude, I think you could do it in less than 90 minutes.
90 minutes. Hey, listen, also, nothing broke, no spare parts.
That's amazing, actually.
No spare parts, no screws that were like, where are these for?
All right, well, there it is. It's back in. It seems to match. Looks good. And I'll give it a couple thumbs up.
Hey, thanks for checking out another episode from the Man Event. We had a great time putting this together. Hey, if you like what you see here, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And if you want to see some more do-it-yourself projects, hey, give us some stuff in the comments. We'll be happy to take a look at what you have to say. Man Event, out.